Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Ritesh Verma from Maharaja Agrasen College, University of Delhi. Today we are going to talk on module Journal, Subdivision of Journal and Ledger, Posting from Paper Accounting and Financial Analysis. To understand the meaning of journal and ledger, to study advantages and important points of journal, to know the rules and subdivision of ledger, to study the distinguish between journal and ledger. Journal. The word journal has been derived from the French word jour, meaning daily records. Journal is a book of prime record for small firms. When the business transactions take place, the first step is to record the same in the books of original entry or subsidiary books or books of prime journal. Thus, journal is a simple book of accounts in which all the business transactions are originally recorded in chronological order and from which they are posted to ledger accounts at a convenient time. Journalizing refers to the act of recording each transaction in the journal, and the form in which it is recorded is known as journal entry. View of different authors. The journal, as originally used, is a book of prime entry in which transactions are copied in order of date from a memorandum or waste book. The entries, as they are copied, are classified into debits and credits so as to facilitate their being correctly posted afterwards in the ledger, given by Professor Carter.
Advantages of journal. The following are the inherent advantages of using journal. Though the transactions can also be directly recorded in the respective ledger accounts. As all the transactions are entered in the journal chronologically, a date-wise record can easily be maintained. All the necessary information and the required explanations regarding all transactions can be obtained from the journal, and errors can be easily located and prevented by the use of journal or book of prime entry. The specimen of journal includes: the first column is of date, second column is of particulars, third column is of ledger folio, and we write it as LF, and fourth column is of debit, and fifth column is of credit. It has five columns all in all: first of date, particulars, ledger folio, amount, debit, and amount credit. And a brief explanation of the transaction by way of narration is given after passing the journal entry.
Date. In each page of journal, at the top of date column, the year is written, and in the next line, month and date of first entry are written. The year and month need not be repeated until a new page has begun or the month or the year changes. Thus, in this column, the date on which the transaction takes place is written only. Particulars. In this column, the details regarding account titles and description are recorded. The name of the account to be debited is entered first. At the extreme left of the particulars column, to the date and the abbreviation DR is written at the right extreme of the same column in the same line. The name of the account to be credited is entered in the next line, preceded by the word to, leaving a few spaces away from the extreme left of the particular column. In the next line, immediately to the account called account credited, a short about the transaction is given, which is known as narration. Narration may include particulars required to identify and understand the transactions and should be adequate enough to explain the transaction. It usually starts with the word being, which means what it is and is written within parentheses. The use of the word being is completely dispensed with in modern parlance. To indicate the completion of the entry for a particular transaction, a line is usually drawn all through the particular column. Ledger folio. This column is meant to record the references of main book, that is ledger, as is not filled in when the transactions are recorded in the journal. The page number of the ledger in which the accounts are appearing is indicated in this column, while the debits and credits are posted to the ledger accounts. Debit amount. This amount is the amount to be debited along with its unit of measurement at the top of this column on each page is written against the account debited. Amount credited or credit amount. The amount to be credited along with its unit of measurement at the top of this column on each page is written against the account credited.
Subdivision of journal. When innumerable number of transactions take place, the journal, as the sole book of the original entry, becomes inadequate. Thus, the number and type of journals required are determined by the nature of operations and the volume of transactions in a particular business. There are many types of journals, and the following are the important ones. Sales daybook, to record all credit sales. Purchases daybook, to record all credit purchases. Cash book, to record all cash transactions of receipts as well as payments. Sales returns daybook, to record the return of goods sold to customers on credit. Purchases returns daybook, to record the return of goods purchased from suppliers on credit. Bills receivable book, to record the details of all the bills received. Bills payable book, to record the details of all the bills accepted. Journal proper, to record all residual transactions which do not find place in any of the aforementioned books of original entry.
Ledger. Ledger is the main book of account in which various accounts of personal, real, and nominal nature are opened and maintained. In journal, as all the business transactions are recorded chronologically, it is very difficult to obtain all the transactions pertaining to one head of account together at one place. But the preparation of different ledger accounts helps to get a consolidated picture of the transactions pertaining to one ledger account at a time. Thus, a ledger account may be defined as a summary statement of all the transactions relating to a person, asset, expense, or income, or gain, or loss, which have taken place during a specified period and shows their net effect ultimately. From this definition, it is clear that when transactions take place, they are first entered in the journal and subsequently posted to the concerned accounts in the ledger. Posting refers to the process of entering in the ledger the information given in the journal. In the past, the ledgers were kept in bound books, but with the passage of time, they became loose leaf ones, and the advantages of the same lie in the removal of completed accounts, insertion of new accounts, and arrangement of accounts in any required manner.
Ruling of ledger account. The ruling of ledger account is as follows. Type 1. First column is of date. Second column is of particulars. Then third column is of journal folio. Fourth column is of amount. This is all about debit side. Now next comes credit side. So we repeat all these columns for credit side also. First column, date. Second column, particulars. Third column is of journal folio. And fourth column is of amount to be written in rupees. Ledger account type 1 is followed in almost all the business concerns. Whereas there is another type of ledger which is called as type 2, which is followed only in banking institutions to save space, time, and clerical work involved. In it, the first column is of date, second is of particulars, and third column is of journal folio. Then fourth column is divided into two parts, debit and credit. Fifth column is again divided into two parts, debit or credit, and in last column, balance is shown. Subdivision of ledger. In a big business, the number of accounts is numerous, and it is found necessary to maintain a separate ledger for customers, suppliers, and for others. Usually, the following three types of ledgers are maintained in such big business concerns. First is debtor's ledger. It contains accounts of all customers to whom goods have been sold on credit. From the sales day book, sales return book, and cash book, the entries are made in this ledger. This ledger is also known as sales ledger. Creditor's ledger. It contains accounts of all suppliers from whom goods have been bought on credit. From the purchases day book, purchases returns book, and cash book, the entries are made in this ledger. This ledger is also known as purchase ledger. Journal ledger. It contains all the residual accounts of real and nominal nature. It is also known as nominal ledger. Distinction between journal and ledger. Journal is a book of prime entry, whereas ledger is a book of final entry. Transactions are recorded daily in the journal, whereas posting in the ledger is made periodically. In the journal, information about a particular account is not found at one place. Whereas in the ledger, information about a particular account is found at one place only. Recording of transactions in the journal is called journalizing, and recording of transactions in the ledger is called posting. A journal entry shows both the aspects, debit as well as credit, but each entry in the ledger shows only one aspect. Narration is written after each entry in the journal, but no narration is given in the ledger. Vouchers, receipts, debit notes, credit notes, etc. from the basic documents form journal entry. Whereas journal constitutes basic records for ledger entries. Some illustrations. Generalize the following transactions in the books of Shankar and Company. June 1 started business with a capital of 60,000. June 2 paid into bank rupees 30,000. June 4 purchased goods from Kamal on credit rupees 10,000. June 6 paid to Shriram rupees 4,920. June 6, discount allowed by him, Rs. 80. June 8, cash sales, Rs. 20,000. June 12, sold to Hamid, Rs. 5,000. June 15, purchased goods from Bharat on credit, Rs. 7,500. June 18, paid salaries, Rs. 4,000. June 20, received from Prem, Rs. 2,480. June 20, allowed him discount, Rs. 20. June 25, withdrew from bank for office use, Rs. 5,000. June 28, withdraw for personal use, Rs. 1,000. June 30, paid Hanif by check, Rs. 3,000. Distinction between bookkeeping and accounting. The difference between bookkeeping and accounting can be summarized in a tabular form as under. In first column, we'll write basis of difference. In second column, we can write bookkeeping, and third column, accounting. On the basis of transactions, bookkeeping, recording of transactions in books of original entry. Accounting, to examine these recorded transactions in order to find out their accuracy. On the basis of posting, bookkeeping, to make posting in ledger. Accounting, to examine this posting in order to ascertain its accuracy. On the basis of total and balance, bookkeeping, to make total of the amount in journal and accounts of ledger, ascertain balance in all the accounts. Accounting, to prepare trial balance with the help of balances of ledger accounts. On the basis of income statement and balance statement, bookkeeping, preparation of trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. Accounting, preparation of trading profit and loss account and balance sheet is included in it. Rectification of errors. These are not included in bookkeeping. These are included in accounting. Special skill and knowledge, bookkeeping. It does not require any special skill and knowledge, as in advanced countries, this work is done by machines. In accounting, it requires special skill and knowledge. Liability. A bookkeeper is not liable for accountancy work. An accountant is liable for the work of bookkeeper. Now, solution to the above mentioned question. In the books of Shankar and Company, date. In the date column, we'll write 2015 and June 1. In the particular columns, we'll write cash account debit. Debit amount, we'll write 60,000. In particular columns, again, we'll write to capital account, and credit side, we'll write 60,000. In summary, we'll write capital brought into the business. The entry to be made on June 2 will be bank account debit Rs. 30,000 to capital account Rs. 30,000, and we'll write summary cash paid into bank. June 4, purchases account debit Rs. 10,000 to Kamal's account Rs. 10,000, purchased goods from Kamal on credit. June 6, Shiram's account debit 4,920 to cash account 4,920. Cash paid to Shriram. June 6, Shriram's account debit Rs. 80 to cash account Rs. 80. June 8, cash account debit Rs. 20,000 to sales account Rs. 20,000. In summary, we'll write cash sales affected. June 12, Hamid's account debit ₹5,000, to sales account ₹5,000. In summary, we'll write goods sold to Hamid, June 15. Purchases account debit ₹7,500 to Bharat's account ₹7,500. In summary, we'll write purchased goods from Bharat, June 18. Salaries account debit ₹4,000 to cash account ₹4,000. In summary, we'll write salaries paid, June 20. Cash account debit ₹2,480 to Prem's account ₹2,480. Cash received from Prem, June 20. Discount account debit ₹20 to Prem's account ₹20. In summary, we'll write discount allowed to Prem, June 25. Cash account debit ₹5,000 to bank account ₹5,000. Cash withdrawn from bank, June 28. Drawings account debit ₹1,000 to cash account ₹1,000. In summary, we'll write cash withdrawn from bank for personal use, June 30. Hanif's account debit ₹3,000 to bank account ₹3,000. In summary, we'll write paid to Hanif by checks. Illustration number 2. Generalize the following transactions. Year 2015, date June 1. Purchased goods worth ₹300 from Vimal and ₹500 from Kamal on credit, June 3. Sale of goods worth ₹1,000 to Balram and ₹700 to Dhanram, June 5. Cash of ₹900 received from Ramasamy and ₹800 from Krishnasamy, June 7. Paid ₹800 to Pradeep and ₹500 to Kuldeep, June 9. Withdrawn from bank ₹600 for office use and ₹300 for personal use. Solution to above question. Date, column will write 2015 and June 1. In particulars column, purchases account debit ₹800 to Vimal's account ₹300 to Kamal's account ₹500. In summary, we'll write purchase goods from Vimal and Kamal on credit, June 3. Balram's account debit ₹1,000. Dhanram's account debit ₹700. To sales account ₹1,700. In summary, we'll write sales of goods to Balram and Dhanram, June 5. Cash account debit ₹1,700. To Ramasamy's account ₹900. To Krishnasamy's account ₹800. In summary, we'll write cash received from Ramasamy and Krishnasamy, June 7. Pradeep's account debit ₹800. Kuldeep's account debit ₹500. To cash account ₹1,300. In summary, we'll write paid Pradeep and Kuldeep, June 9. Cash account debit ₹600. Drawings account debit ₹300. To bank account ₹900. In summary, we'll write withdrawn from bank for office use and personal use. Illustration number 3. Generalize the following transactions. Post the same in relevant ledger account and balance the same. Date 2014, June 1. Karthik commenced business with ₹20,000. June 2. Paid into bank ₹5,000. June 3. Purchased plant worth ₹10,000 from Modi and Company, June 4. Purchased goods worth ₹5,000 from Anwar, June 6.
goods worth rupees 4000 sold to Anbu. June 8, sold goods worth rupees 2000 for cash. June 10, goods returned by Anbu rupees 50. June 15, paid rent rupees 250. June 18, withdrawn from bank for office use rupees 2500. June 20, paid salaries rupees 1800. June 25, withdrawn for personal use rupees 250. June 26, goods returned to Anwar rupees 100. June 27, paid for office furniture rupees 1500 by check. June 28, received rupees 3900 cash from Anbu and discount allowed rupees 50. June 29, paid Anwar on account rupees 4800 and discount allowed by him rupees 100. Solution to the above illustration. In the books of Shankar and Company, date column 2014 June 1, particulars column, cash account debit rupees 20,000 to Karthik's capital account rupees 20,000. Summary: capital brought into the business by Karthik. June 2, bank account debit rupees 5,000 to cash account rupees 5,000. Summary: cash paid into bank. June 3, plant account debit rupees 10,000 to Modi and company's account rupees 10,000. Summary: plant purchased from Modi and company. June 4, purchase account debit rupees 5,000 to Answer's account rupees 5,000. Summary: goods purchased from Anwar. June 6, Anbu's account debit rupees 4,000 to sales account rupees 4,000. Summary: goods sold to Anbu. June 8, cash account debit rupees 2,000 to sales account rupees 2,000. Summary: goods sold for cash. June 10, sales returns account debit rupees 50 to Anbu's account rupees 50. Summary: goods returned by Anbu. June 15, rent account debit rupees 250 to cash account rupees 250. Summary: rent paid. June 18, cash account debit rupees 2500 to bank account rupees 2500. Summary: withdrawn from bank for office use. June 20, salaries account debit rupees 1800 to cash account rupees 1800. Summary: salaries paid. June 25, drawing account debit rupees 250 to cash account rupees 250. Summary: withdrawn for personal use. June 26, Anwar's account debit rupees 100 to purchases returns account rupees 100. Summary: goods returned to Anwar. June 27, furniture account debit rupees 1500 to bank account rupees 1500. Summary: payment by check for office furniture. June 28, cash account debit rupees 3900, discount account debit rupees 50 to Anbu's account 3950. Summary: cash received from Anbu and discount allowed rupees 50. June 29, Anwar's account debit rupees 4900 to cash account rupees 4800 to discount account rupees 100. Summary: cash paid to Anwar and discount allowed by him. Ledger account, cash account. In date column, June 1. Particulars column, of debit side, to Karthik's capital account, amount 20,000. June 2. On credit side, we'll write under date column, June 2. Under particular columns, we'll write by bank account, rupees 5,000. June 8. Debit side, to sales account, rupees 2,000. June 15. Credit side, by rent account, rupees 250. Now debit side, June 18. To bank account, rupees 2,500. June 20. On credit side, by salaries account, rupees 1,800. Again on credit side, June 25. By drawings account, rupees 250. Now June 28. On debit side, to Anbu's account, rupees 3,900. Now on credit side, June 29. By Anwar's account, rupees 4,800. Again on credit side, June 30. By balance carried down, rupees 16,300. Total on both sides is now 28,400. So we'll carry down this balance of last entry which we made on June 30th. By balance carried down, 16,300. This is balancing amount which we entered just to balance these two accounts. Now on July 1st, we'll bring this balance towards debit side by writing on the debit side to balance brought down 16,300. Bank account, debit side, June 2. To cash account, rupees 5,000. Credit side, June 18. By cash account, rupees 2,500. June 27. By furniture account, rupees 1,500. June 30. By balance carried down, rupees 1,000. Now total is 5,000. On July 1st, on debit side, we'll write to balance brought down, rupees 1,000. Next, Karthik's capital account. Credit side, date June 1. By cash account, rupees 20,000. Debit side, June 30. To balance carried down, rupees 20,000. Now credit side, July 1. By balance carried down, rupees 20,000. Next, plant account. Debit side, June 3. To Modi and Company's account, 10,000. Credit side, by balance carried down, 10,000 on June 30. Now on debit side, we'll write on June 1, we'll make an entry on July 1 as to balance carried down, rupees 10,000. Modi and Company's account. Credit side, June 3. By plant account, rupees 10,000. Debit side, June 30. To balance carried down, rupees 10,000. July 1. Credit side, by balance brought down, rupees 10,000. Next, purchases account. Debit side, June 4. To Anwar's account, rupees 5,000. Credit side, June 30. By balance carried down, rupees 5,000. Now on debit side, July 1. To balance brought down, rupees 5,000. Next, Anwar's account. Credit side, June 4. By purchases account, rupees 5,000. Debit side, June 26. To purchases returns account, rupees 100. June 29. To cash account, on debit side, rupees 4,800. On debit side, June 29. To discount, rupees 100. Ledger balance total, rupees 5,000 on both sides. Next, sales account. Credit side, June 6. By Anbu's account, rupees 4,000. June 8. By cash account, rupees 2,000. June 30. On debit side, to balance carried down, rupees 6,000. July 1. Credit side, to balance brought down ₹6,000. Next, Anbu's account, debit side, June 6, to sales account, ₹4,000. Credit side, June 10, by sales returns account, ₹50. Credit side, June 28, by cash account, ₹3,900. Credit side, June 28, by discount account, ₹50. Ledger total, ₹4,000 on both sides. Next, purchases returns account. Credit side, June 26. By inverse account, ₹100. June 30, debit side. To balance, carry down, 100. Credit side, July 1. By balance brought down, ₹100. Next, sales returns account. Debit side, June 10. To Anbu's account, ₹50. Credit side, June 30. By balance, carry down, ₹50. Ledger total, 50 on each side. Now, on June 1, on debit side, to balance brought down, ₹50. Next, furniture account. June 27, on debit side, to bank account, ₹1,500. Credit side, June 30, by balance carry down, ₹1,500. Ledger total, 1,500 on both sides. On debit side, June 1, to balance brought down, 1,500. Next, discount account. Debit side of discount account. June 28, to Anbu's account, ₹50. June 29, credit side. By inverse account, ₹100. Now on debit side, June 30, balance carry down, ₹50. Balance equals 100 on each side. On July 1, on credit side, by balance brought down, ₹50. Next, drawings account. June 25, on debit side, to Anbu's account, ₹250. Credit side, June 30, by balance carry down, ₹250. Ledger balance equals on both sides, ₹250. On debit side, July 1, to balance brought down, ₹250. Next, rent account. Debit side, June 15, to cash account, ₹250. Credit side, June 30, by balance carry down, ₹250. Ledger balance equals ₹250 on both sides. Now on June 1, on debit side, we'll make entry to balance brought down, ₹250. Next, salaries account. Debit side, June 20. To cash account, ₹1,800. June 30. Credit side, by balance carry down, ₹1,800. Now ledger balance equal 1,800 on both sides. On July 1st, we'll brought down the balance on debit side by writing to balance brought down 1,800.
So students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Business transactions are first entered in the records in the form of journal. As per the double entry system of accounting, we have to classify the accounts and apply the double accounting rule accordingly. Then, in order to summarize the accounts, posting should be done through ledgers. Ledger is a main book of account in which various accounts of personal, real, and nominal nature are opened and maintained. When more than two accounts are involved in a transaction, it is recorded by means of single journal entry instead of passing several journal entries. Such single journal entry is termed as compound journal entry. A compound journal entry may also be passed if there are more transactions of the same nature taking place on the same date. Thank you.